Por la encendida calle antillana va, tembandumba de la guimbamba. Rumba macumba candombe bambula, rumba macumba candombe bambula, rumba macumba candombe bambula. Entre dos filas de negras caras, ante ella un congo, congo y maraca. Rima una conga, bomba que bamba. Culipandeando la reina avanza, y de su inmensa grupa resbalan meneos cachondos que el congo cuaja en ríos de azúcar y de melaza. Prieto trapiche de sensual zafra, el caderamen, masa con masa, exprime ritmos, suda que sangra y la molienda culmina en danza.
Capotea, capotea, ay, bupe, calinda, capotea, ay, bupe, siampu, capotea, capotea,
y por la encendida calle antillana va, tembandumba de la quimbamba. Flor de tortola, rosa de Uganda, por ti crepitan bombas y bámbulas. Por ti en calendas desenfrenadas, quema la antilla su sangre ñáñiga. Haití te ofrece sus calabazas, fogosos rones te da Jamaica. Cuba te dice, maní, 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 maní cero se va, maní.
He can't catch her. You will catch her.
He'll lose her in the bush.
He'll catch her.
Why do you think he's gonna catch her?
Because Tonya wants to be caught.
Why do you think Tonya wants to be caught?
Because she likes the Spaniard.
Don't be foolish. She doesn't pay him any mind.
Maybe she's only says that. You understand?
Of course I understand. Maybe that's not what she means.
The Spaniard has been after Tonya for days.
Heavens, Mask. Why do you say that?
She's got a devil in her today, and he'll catch her in the bushes.
Let me cover up my ears.
Those Spaniards always take off the prettiest dark girl.
What did you say?
The Spaniards always carry off the prettiest brown girls.
What are you worrying about? We all know that brown girls love the Spaniards. Let's go and dance.
There's nothing to worry about. These things, they can easily be fixed. I told you, these things can easily be fixed. Tomorrow I shall talk to your father, first thing in the morning.
I can't go home.
Of course you can go home.
You know my father. He is capable of cutting me with a machete.
I say I know him. I have bought thousands of coconuts for my shop from him. He usually splits them with one thumb of his machete.
He'll do the same with me.
Well, just think of it. You lose your head and do anything foolish, both of us will be buried. And all of that for just a piece of foolishness between a man and a woman? Half of this village was born in the same way.
What am I going to do?
Listen carefully to what I'm going to tell you. And don't argue. Cheer up, there is nothing to worry about. You'll easily get out of this business. In the first place, you had better fix your head and your dress, okay? What happened to your tongue? Have you swallowed it?
I'll fix myself.
That's fine. In the second place, you go back to the dance as though nothing had happened. You tell the people that I couldn't catch you, understand?
I see.
What do you see?
Nothing.
Shut up, I say! Alright, you dance for a little while, then you go back home. As usual, you ask for your parents' blessing, and then you say goodnight, and you go to bed.
To bed?
Of course. And you have my absolute promise that you will see me first thing tomorrow morning. First thing.
Thanks.
Take my advice. Everything will work out all right.
And what about my father? What are you going to say to him?
To your father? You must make an effort not to get annoyed. If any indiscretion of yours makes your father suspect what has happened, it will be goodbye to your head, and it will be goodbye to mine. I am sure of that, as I am sure that Alfonso XIII reigns over Spain, and that the Americans stole Puerto Rico from us 10 years ago.
But what about my father? What are you going to say to him? What?
Would you like to wash my clothes and cook my food for me?
They?
Don't take it that way. There are reasons for making this suggestion. Come now, none of the women think with their head, whether black or white. What are you crying for if I am going to fix everything? Should I let what happened? Were you like this? How many women in the village started out this way? And now they are selling themselves on the streets of San Juan. There is a little wooden house behind my shop. You can have it for as long as you want. Be calm. It's just for the time being. Soon I shall be able to look after you in a better way. My brother, he's well established in San Juan, and if he knew anything about this, he would cause me a lot of trouble. People back home in Spain, they want to marry me off to some girl from my village. I don't want to upset them. They don't understand that a man may fall in love in the West Indies. They say that African blood should stay overseas.
You needn't bother about me. You act as if you are talking about an animal, rather than a human being!
The peace and love, don't lose the only way which can keep us together. It is true that I shall ask your father to let you work for me as a servant. There is nothing else we can do. But in the shop, when I have closed up everything for the day, then we shall be alone together. Sonia will be for me the prettiest brown girl and the best surrounded by deaths around the whole island!
And what if there is a child?
We'll speak of that in due course.
Tell me, what are you going to do if a child is born?
I will dress him and feed him. You know what to do? Tomorrow morning, no foolishness, no nerves. You will be my servant in the daytime, but at night you will be my queen. As time goes on and things change, who knows? We may be able to fix things better.
Then you are able to raise your voice to me. And until that time, you are going to listen to what I say and do it as I like it. There are things in this world that you do not know. And when you are ready to put your hands in the dirt and do them for yourself, then you are able to raise your voice to me. But until that time, you are going to listen to what I say and do it as I like it. There are things in this world that you do not know. And when you are ready to put your hands in the dirt and do them for yourself, then you are able to raise your voice to me. But until that time, you are going to listen to what I say and do it as I like it.
Por la encendida calle Antillana va, tembandumba de la guimbamba. Rumba macumba candombe bambula, rumba macumba candombe bambula, rumba macumba candombe bambula. Entre dos filas de negras caras, ante ella un congo, congo y maraca. Rima una conga, bomba que bamba.
Who put out the light?
Pulipandeando las
rejas. Why are you leaving me in the dark? I can't understand why you always smoke light in the house.
And I can't understand your habit of living like a rat bat.
That's for the dead. Darkness is for the dead.
I like to see myself as I am, cotton and coffee.
Who gave you that record?
Let it finish!
Gave it to you!
Clarita! She knows how much that kind of music enchants me. She knows I love it and she brought it from San Juan yesterday afternoon. Listen, in spite of everything, my granddaughter loves me. I could hardly believe that she would bring me that old record, but she did. She even kissed me the first time in many years. I thanked her from the bottom of my heart, and the poor dear started to cry. Marta, daughter, my granddaughter really is a good girl.
Take it. Keep it in your room and don't bring it out again.
There is nothing to make such a fuss about. Just because you're a school mistress doesn't mean you can go around despising the music and dance of your own country. I worked hard so that you could study. And after all, what was I? Just a rumba dancer? And it took me a lot to convince Benedicto, the wretched man. Didn't even want to give you an education. If it had not been for my tears, you would be like brown sugar with the smell of molasses on you.
As an educated person, I should set an example to this residential suburb. This music, if such can be called, is disgusting.
Oh, well, we didn't dance anything else in Loíza, where I was brought up. The Spaniard, who was your father, courted me around to the sounds of these drums, and the wicked man used to close up shop at 6 o'clock on Saturday. And then off he went to dance. And what a dancer he was. He started to take his first steps before the morning sun had gone down, and he was still staggering in when the morning light came up. How he used to encourage the farmers. I hope that God will let him dance up there in heaven. You see, if your father was a Spaniard, and he wasn't finicky about dancing our native dances.
Mama Tonia, we're living in the capital now. The neighbors can't stand this music. They associate it with,
the Negroes, my daughter. All those posh people out there, what do they dance? Tell me, what do they dance? Just the rumba and mama, in order to marry off their daughters as quickly as possible.
Well, I've told you before, this is not suitable music for this place. It is disgusting noise.
All right. Is there any way suffering for a colored person to live in a house with their white children?
Please don't start that.
All right. All right, my daughter. I was happy in the village of Louisa. I used to run free along the shore. I used to play in the white sand. And I danced for as long as I wanted underneath the flamboyant trees. Of course I could. I danced for hours and hours outside of Nopinia's hut. Nopinia, the best drummer in Louisa. People used to stand around and I would make the most graceful movements with my body. If you could have seen how your father used to look at me, he was like a lizard after a wasp. Nobody used to shut me up in the back room in those days.
And who shuts you up now?
You. If you could, you would put a lock on the door.
Listen, Mama Tonia, try to understand. Please, try to understand.
I know what you mean. Put up with any treatment we give you and keep your mouth shut.
Well, let's be calm. We mustn't quarrel. There will be better days. First of all, we've got to marry Clarita.
Oh, I see what you're coming to now.
As soon as she is married and gone to live in the States, we can go back to Louisa.
Why has she got to go so far?
I want her to live outside Puerto Rico. I don't want her to be troubled by our past.
Our past is inside of us to the hour of our death. Whether here or in the Philippines.
Mother, we will go back to Louisa. There you can breathe freely again.
Without Clarita.
Her happiness justifies any sacrifice. Let us give her an opportunity of a better life.
I sometimes think she should live our life. In the end, she will suffer less.
No! Here people live miserable lives. We are condemned by bitterness. Too much bitterness. We suffer in silence endlessly.
That's because of poor old Mama Tonia and the Spaniard who was dazzled.
Listen, tonight, quite soon, we will be receiving a visit from Bill, Clarita's fiancé.
I thought as much. I thought as much. I've seen all the things you bought. Your fat husband, as mean and greedy as he was, must be turning in his grave.
I beg of you, try to understand.
Don't waste your time. Let them hide me away in the darkest corner of the house and I will hold my breath. Is that what you want? Well, I've learned to do it a long time ago.
As soon as she is engaged to Bill completely. As soon as her marriage is fixed.
Not even your father. Who never had to cover his face with white powder trying to humiliate me this way. It is true that he never married me. May the devil forgive him down in the depths of hell where he probably is. But at least he introduced me to his friends. His friends assumed that I was his wife, accepted me as his wife. And your husband, that wonderful husband of yours, an Austin Grocer. More like a bear than a human being, drunk and foul-mouthed and rough. He used to walk me around the city, a city which his ancestors defended against the English. I am grateful to that pair of Spaniards for a respect that I cannot be more grateful to, Your Majesty. By witchcraft, my daughter. People born in Elisa know all about witchcraft.
You hid in the passage. What would have happened if Bill had gone inside the house?
Nonsense! I didn't hide in any passage. I found out by the means of spirits. Martha and the spirits, they told me that the red tomato had discovered the secret of the turban.
Oh, don't talk foolishness!
You should really let me buy you some herbs so I can rid you of those evil spirits.
Stop! You're making my headache!
Daughter, Martha, you are very unhappy. I think I would be doing you a favor by dying and leaving my will to be buried in a common grave. Then you will be well rid of me.
Oh, let's finish this conversation. Bill will be coming very soon.
And they say that slavery was abolished in 1873. I am not talking about my grandfather's, which was abolished much earlier. I am thinking of yours. Your blind adoration to the white skin, which is the same as yours and mine.
You know that all I'm trying to do is help my daughter.
What help can you be bringing to her, to a tortured conscience? And this American, do you really think he is sincere?
All Americans are very nice people.
Look, if the man is giving no guarantee, the best thing Clarita can do is wait and ask St. Anthony for another red tomato. I mean, if the man must come from New York.
Bill isn't from New York.
Where is he from?
From Alabama in the southern states.
Isn't that where they lynch colored people?
Well, not very often. It's not like it used to be.
People who can go to those extremes, even if it's only once.
Well, Matonya, let's finish this conversation. Police, Bill will be here any moment now.
Martha, don't ruin your daughter's future. Scheme can deceive like the devil.
When Bill proposes to Clarita, I shall ask all the necessary questions.
He hasn't said anything to the girl yet?
Nothing. On the contrary, he hasn't been here for a whole week.
I thought something was up since the day they went down to the beach in Loquillo.
And you say that you don't hear them from out here.
Martha, believe me, this masquerade cannot be the true way. Your father, dressed up in a carnival mask, took me away from the true way. And that is why your turban seemed cut out of those colors.
Why? Think. Just think. Why do you think I took the initiative of inviting Bill over here?
It was you who invited him.
Yes, it was I.
Why?
To rid our daughter from those masks. I don't want her life to be a bad dream of fear and refusal. I don't want her to be troubled by our past. Mama Tonya! Bill is a suitable husband for Clarita in every way. He is white. He lives outside of this country. If he falls seriously in love with the girl, he will take her away. In the States, Clarita will have nothing more to fear.
And what about her conscience?
Well, the new setting will cure her from this Puerto Rican stupidities.
Martha, there are some worms who grow fat under the skin.
Listen. Let us do everything to save her. Each one does it in her own way. Let Bill free her from this ghost.
Doctor, marriage with so many masks can only bring about immense bitterness. You have gone through that fire. That Austrian who married you thought he was superior. And when he was enraged, said awful things about Puerto Ricans. You live with him, so you ought to know.
Oh, Mother, please don't drive me to despair.
Martha, there will never be peace between us. Thank you for the record, Clarita.
I'll bring you some more, Abella.
I never thought I'd hear a record of that old song again.
The recording was made by the government.
Christina even looked more beautiful.
I was born lucky.
Carita.
Yes, abuela?
I was advising your mother of young men and their ideas here and not here.
I don't understand.
Well, I just mean that as soon as Americans step foot onto Puerto Rico, they start to conceal their true thoughts.
I suppose you're referring to Bill.
Well, I'm not calling any names.
There's nothing to worry about, Bill. He's just a good friend.
You have been out with him day after day, night after night.
That does not mean anything.
Well, I don't want to interfere, but young people today don't go dancing just to dance.
The director of the firm I work for asked me to take Bill around and show him the town. Everybody needs to know where all of the business people are likely to gather.
That's a nice assignment, I must say. You didn't go to a university to end up as a tour guide. Why doesn't your boss go trotting him around himself?
It's one of my duties in the personnel department. I'm supposed to look after salesmen sent down from the States. I take them everywhere, from Smart Dances in the Condado to country drugstores.
I don't like that kind of assignment. As soon as you can, get out of that insurance company. People who can make money off the misfortunes of others cannot be very honest.
Well, I am 25 years old, and up to now, I've looked after myself quite effectively.
There are whirlpools in life, my child. And when we least expect it, we find ourselves being drawn down.
For example?
Marriage for the sake of marriage isn't worth it. It's best you wait for a decent man to come along. You have plenty of time. The house is yours, and you've inherited quite a bit of money from that grizzly bear of a father you had. As far as I'm concerned, as a woman, you are worthy of a king. You don't have to be taken in by any smart aleck with bells on his horns and the devil in his heart.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Mama, shut up and go to your room.
You scream at me as if I'm a piece of dirt or a girl on the street.
For Christ's sake, just go.
And supposing I decide not to go.
Abuela, Mama, please stop it.
And supposing I decide to pluck myself there off a cotton tree.
They are hurting each other.
Here, to the four winds. Roots in the earth and branches in the sun. The way that all the sons and daughters of this land should be. Mama Tona or Tonya, it's all the same. Buried alive so that Marta, her daughter, blood of her womb, blood of her blood, can pretend that I don't exist.
What are you trying to do? Ruin Clarita's life? Don't say that. This sort of life cannot continue. Answer me! Please, don't go on with it.
What greater madness is there in the world? Screaming and screaming like a monkey. That's what it is. Screaming like a monkey. Take revenge on my daughter. Hurt my granddaughter? How could you think of such a terrible thing for a poor old woman with one foot in the grave? You can't stand the sight of me, of my color. And you have never appreciated how much I love you. You are my white granddaughter.
Mama, you drive me to distraction. I am so overwrought. I didn't mean what I said. I was just thinking that Bill might come through that door any moment and be patient. Help me. I need your help, not for me. My life is over, but for Clarita and her happiness. Bill wouldn't understand, you see.
I see.
If he suspected, he would never come back here.
Like the devil runs from the cross.
I told you we will go back to Louisa. You will see Nopeña's grandchildren. You will walk on the beach again, and you will visit the Fiesta of Santiago, I promise.
All right. You stop screeching like a raging monkey. You're more like a Christian now.
Mama Tonia, please go to your room for just a few hours.
All right. But don't go ordering me around like you were doing just now. You can sleep soundly tonight. I am going to satisfy you. But tomorrow, I shall leave this house. I am going to a home for old people.
No!
There, I shall have companions in misfortune. Here, I am alone, surrounded by thunder and lightning. I know they say that old people let out more bile than rotten bananas. But they are much friendlier, and that's what really matters.
Abuela, you must not leave this house.
Clarita, it is the best thing for everybody. Here, I am a prickly bush among you, so you might as well take that machete to the bush.
Don't say such things. You are good.
There are some songs, like the singing of the nightingale. Yes, my daughters. Like the singing of the nightingale in the cool of the early morning. Thank you, Clarita. May God bless you. Hold on. Here. When you get a moment to spare, listen to it. Your grandfather dressed up in a carnival mask and danced it with me one night in the Fiesta of Santiago.
I've often thought about that night, Abuela. I have often thought about that night of Santiago.
And you, madam, with your turban on, trying to look so much like a stormy sky.
Problem. I can see him.
of this world.
Absolute heaven.
I have been saving up this surprise for a month. The most lovely beach in Puerto Rico on its bluest morning.
I'll say. Wow, gosh, it's a beauty. A real beauty. You know, the ones in Miami, they produce millions of dollars, and there's just no comparison. You ever seen the beaches in Miami?
Yes, but this is better.
I'll say. What sun? What colors? What air? Oh, there's millions of dollars just buried here. All it needs is a little bit of fixing. Hundreds of thousands of Americans would love to invade it.
Phil?
What?
A penny for your thoughts?
Oh, I suppose there's just one thing I don't like.
Let's hear it. What displeases the American God?
I don't like seeing so many white folk going around with niggers. That sort of thing just spoils the charm. It's a pity.
Yes, it's a pity.
Most American tourists just don't like that sort of thing.
I'm sorry, Bill. In that case, Lupillo Beach is lost for the tourists of that kind. The people of Puerto Rico have been using this beach for years. They come here and they enjoy it, and nobody is going to drive them off of it. When they run on its sands and refresh their bodies in its waters, they forget about race.
So it don't bother you none that blacks and whites should mix?
No.
Well, I must confess, frankly, I can't stand it.
So then you'd better not try to live in Puerto Rico.
In my business, it's okay. It's just, in my private life, I can't stand it.
Don't you think we should go and swim?
Now why are you vexed?
The sort of conversation spoils the day.
Come on, I got something I want to tell you. Just sit down.
No, Bill, I prefer...
Please, will you?
I'd rather...
Will you? Now, honey, I talked honestly with you the other day because, well, from your kisses, I realized that you seemed to like me quite a bit. And in the second, I know you are white. 100%.
And if I were not?
You couldn't fool me. I know you're an intelligent woman, and that you'll fess up to a lot of things that most Puerto Ricans haven't got the courage to.
For example?
Well, with the business about colored blood. Now, an intelligent woman understands what a Southerner would be to suffer if,
Go on.
Well, if he had mixed his blood with Negro blood. A child like that would drive him insane.
Can prejudice do that to people?
It ain't prejudice. It's the way of thinking about things in the whole of the South.
And it would be quite impossible for you to overcome it.
God preserve me. When I think of my parents, old Southern family, fighters for white supremacy, why? If anything like that happened to me, they'd never want to see me again as long as I lived. Might even kill them. It would be a terrible disgrace. You know, in the office, they's always asking me, have you found out what Doña Marta's hiding under her turkey? Have you found out what Doña Marta's hiding under
they
her turban?
They say that to you?
What is all this business about your mother's turban anyhow? I have complete trust in your word.
Bill, I don't think we should try and see each other for a few days.
Why, honey?
It's a problem and we must solve it in our consciences.
Now, come on. I know that you are a beautiful woman and I want to kiss you. And I want to make love to you.
No, Bill.
Please, stay.
Please let me go now alone.
Honey.
If you are a Southern gentleman and you say you come from a good family, don't insist.
Please,
I don't want you to follow me.
Santo Mar, Santo Mar, Santo Mar.
And Don Yamada.
How nice of you to come.
It is indeed a pleasure.
Please, make yourself at home.
Thank you.
Cross my heart, Bill will miss you a lot.
Antonia Marta. And Clarita?
Oh, she will soon be ready.
Fine. Perhaps I have a surprise for her tonight.
Perhaps.
Well, it's almost certain.
Would you like to take off your jacket?
Oh, if you don't mind. It's hellishly hot out tonight.
Well, a hurricane is forming in the Eastern Caribbean.
A hurricane? Really? Well, when was it announced?
How cute. It's a joke. But a whirlwind certainly hit Luquillo Beach last week.
A whirlwind in... Oh, yes, yes, I see. But only two people knew about it.
Well, the third does not know the details. Don't worry, Bill. Everything will work out to everybody's satisfaction. Let me hang up your jacket.
Don't you, Marta?
Yes, Bill?
You know, for days now, I've been trying to think of who exactly you resemble.
Do you remember now?
Yes. I knew a couple of Italians up in New York. They have the same type as you. Same skin, features.
Well, a couple of my friends who've been to Italy have told me the same thing. At least he doesn't have to put up with our tropical heat anymore. How he used to curse and swear about it. He used to always been dreaming about the climate of northern Spain where he came from.
Well, Puerto Rican sun's a great thing.
But one thing annoyed him more than the heat. Same as with my father. They came from the Asturias and they never got used to the appearance of certain Puerto Ricans. They were real old-fashioned Spaniards.
Old-fashioned?
Yes, they did not believe in the mixing with people of African descent.
I see. Same as we think in South.
More or less. Bill?
Oh, Tony Marta, you are indeed a most charming person.
Since the cocktails were for you, I made them with a very special rum.
Well, thank you.
It tastes like old brandy.
Really?
Really.
How did they get it like that?
Well, it is cured in Spanish wine casks, whose wood has been soaked into by wine.
How interesting.
So it turns out to be a Puerto Rican product with a Spanish ancestry, like the lady who's talking to you and her daughter.
Wonderful. I'll have to take a couple of bottles back home to my pub. You know, I might even try to put it on sale back in the States. Where can I get some?
On an old estate between Cantano and Bayamon.
An old estate, huh? Boy, that's familiar words. Feel like I was drinking back in an old house in Alabama.
And why not? We are in the Southern States.
Sure we are.
For the Old South.
Damn the Yankees. You know, this sure is an interesting country. Imagine finding Puerto Ricans drinking in the Old South.
Has it never struck you that we're very much alike? Hasn't it?
Sure, in a way.
Of course, in some ways. In others, like the mixing of races going everywhere, well, there the similarity ends. Oh, do sit down, Bill.
Oh, thank you. No sign of Clarita yet.
Oh, she will soon be here.
I hope she don't mind.
Oh, of course not. She was very pleased when you accepted my invitation.
Are you sure?
Sure, I am sure.
Don't you, Marta? You see, I never thought that Clarita... She's just so sweet, you know, so gentle.
Why? What happened?
Well, it's a bit hard to explain.
There are no mysteries which can't be solved. When I taught school, I used to sort out the most difficult cases. I am all confidence, Bill. Another?
Oh, I must admit I had a couple of highballs just before I came. I was a bit scared. Your parents, Don Marta, were they both Spanish?
Both. I thought I told you already.
Now, I remember you did not mention your mother.
I thought. Oh, well, what does it matter? Of course, mother was Spanish. She came from southern Spain. That's why I got my Italian appearance. You know, southern Spaniards and Italians look very much alike.
I see. And another question? Perhaps a bit stupider than the first.
Stupid? Why, I think it's quite natural.
Have you?
What?
Have you any pictures of your mother?
Oh, no. Mother did not like being photographed.
And why not?
She was rather odd in a way. She wanted us to remember her in our hearts.
It's just a shame that she left no pictures at all.
I am so sorry, Bill, but in fact, she looked very much like me.
It's okay, as long as she was Spanish. And what I'm going to say next might seem a bit offensive to you, but I must say, just to get it off my mind...
Offensive?
Donnie Marta, they ask me the same question every day. Have you found out what Donya Marta's hiding under her turban?
And you've been losing sleep over that foolishness. Why didn't you ask me from the first? It would have saved you a lot of trouble, Bill, really.
Donya Marta, it's just... Well, you know, Clarita had answered my question from the first, but she did. And then in the second, she told me she didn't want to see me anymore. You gotta understand.
If you want, all I have to do is invest in this
fruit. No, don't go on about it. I feel ashamed as is.
But as far as I'm concerned, it does not matter.
It's okay. Instead of all this nonsense, you know, I got a good piece of news for you. My knowledge of Spanish has gotten me a better job.
How wonderful, in Puerto Rico or abroad?
Back in the States. I got the wire just after you called. I will be the public relations officer for our Latin American contacts.
Oh, congratulations!
Thank you. I ship out tomorrow night.
Clarita will be very pleased about your promotion, but she will be sorry you have to leave.
Actually, I was thinking maybe Clarita could come with me and work in the States at a better job than she has now. You know, that is, if she'd like and you don't object.
Object? I should say not. You can count on me from now on. The child needs to get out of this nigger-ridden setup we have in here. She will be much happier.
We ought to drink to Clarita. You know, I've been awfully sorry to miss her company.
Yes. Well, to Clarita.
To
Good
Clarita.
Good luck to both of you in the States. I'll go see what Clarita is doing.
People.
flamboyance will look wonderful in the moonlight.
No.
Well, why not?
He would be walking with the whole of Puerto Rico.
Forget about the other day at Mequillo Beach. Listen, we should just go on for a walk. The moonlight makes the garden look like heaven.
We should look at the flowers with a clear conscience. Otherwise, we won't be able to see them properly.
What's the matter? I thought you weren't upset anymore.
Bill, let's sit down.
Well, why don't you have a drink?
No.
Alcohol brightens up life, you know. Makes the garden look beautiful.
I said no. I want to see the garden as it really is. Feel the hardness of the ground as I walk on it. Breathe its real air. And hear the true meaning of words.
I thought you weren't upset no more.
Bill?
Go on, honey.
They have been making a fool's paradise for you.
What?
It's not right for you to walk in the garden without knowing the whole truth. Mother is the daughter of a Spaniard and a brown girl from Louisa. My grandfather never had the courage to marry my grandmother. He told everyone she was his maid. My mother was brought up with double the shame, at war with herself. Her character was twisted from early on by the fear of being humiliated. Time went by, she became embittered and wretched and miserable. She felt that she had lost her right to happiness, but she wanted it for her daughter, at any cost. Roots such as these have caused great unhappiness in Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico!
Since the beginning, I have struggled with myself to confess all of this to you. It was your behavior at the beach in Lucio that drove me to make up my mind.
You have to be joking.
No, Bill. This is not a time for joking. You are witnessing a case of bad roots. They torture and deform many people, like my mother.
I have been made a victim of a vile piece of deceit.
Now I feel free to walk in the garden with you. I invite you.
They have no shame.
Were they or were they not the last kisses?
Bloody devil, what sort of bloody country am I even in? Don't you worry, I want you to come in here.
Oh, yes, Bill, I'll be right with you. Bill, see her as she is. A blind mother, you must forgive her.
She has played a dangerous game that could have endangered the purity of my blood.
Make an effort. Try to think.
Why don't you even let me kiss you? I feel like I want to vomit.
I thought you were better than this irrational hatred.
Filthy, stinking pig. Is it true that you have nigger blood?
Oh, Bill!
Answer me!
I can't understand. I've given you an opportunity of a better life without the old wounds which I've longed for, even before you were a dream, and now you throw it away without any reason? There are worse wounds in the world than ours, Mother. Answer him. Answer Bill as you should! You know already, Mama and I have Negro blood, which we inherited from our grandmother. Let us live face to face with this Puerto Rican reality. Without all of the disguises that turn this country into a nightmare of masks. Let us remove these masks and look for true happiness.
Clarita, you have ruined all my hopes.
But I love you more. I understand your lies, and I am not ashamed of them. I know that behind them there is a pure heart. Tear out once and for all these roots which are poisoning your life. Pull them out yourself. You must do it. Take them with your will and cast them into oblivion. Behind all of that bitterness and resentment, there is still love in
Listen,
you.
Listen, you just take that thing off your head.
Bill, don't humiliate her.
Didn't you hear what I said? Take off that turban.
Here, for a southern gentleman.
Lizard, you take that thing off your head.
Let go of me!
Get out of her. You bitch!
Sir! You are behaving like a wild beast!
Who the hell are you?
One of the Lord's black sheep.
Who is this?
Don't confess your sins to the devil!
Damn you!
What did you say? Talk like a Christian!
You bastard witch!
I don't know what you mean, but as it seems though you stink like a rotten coconut, I suppose it can't be anything good.
I hate every inch of this damn country!
It seems as if the devil has gotten into his body. In case it may help you, let me put the sign of the cross over you.
Don't you dare touch me, you dirty nigger. Don't you stay away or I'll...
Away, Satan! Leave the body of the red Oh, we shall see who is stronger. Your evil power or the brown girl from Palm Village, who has known you for years. Oh, wait. I have a spell that will work against you. Away!
To hell with all of you!
Go burn in your own hell! Allow me to lock the door in case he decides to come back. It was high time we got rid of him. What are you crying for? You should be pleased about what has happened.
Listen, Mama. Mama Tonya insists on leaving us. She intends to go to a home for old people.
No.
I tried to tell her not to go, but she insists. You are not leaving this house.
And who is going to stop me?
Don't make me more miserable than I am. I had a rough night.
It's all right. It's all right. Clarita has to be married, and I shall leave this house to avoid any difficulties for her.
Be calm, very calm. We must not talk without masks and speak sincerely from our heart. Mama Tonya, please stay for just a few minutes. Please.
Just 1 minute, not a second more.
We must think of ourselves with complete calm. We only have one life, and we're making a mess of it. It is I who should have cried, but I have not shed one tear. I can't cry. I tell you again, I am not sorry that Bill is gone. He is probably out, drowning himself in whiskey to wipe us out of his memory. For since he was a child, a hatred as poisonous as a centipede has been festering in his soul. He cannot love us as we are. We create a nightmare terror in him. All we can do is hope that his conscience may be kind to him and that his prejudice he may free himself from his prejudice. Meanwhile, let's think of our home, where three human beings live like billiard balls, always knocking into one another. Let's think. There are deep bonds between these three humans. Grandmother, daughter, and granddaughter. We must get on together somehow. We must start on a new footing. What do you think, Abuela? All right, an idea. Let's listen to the record.
Thank you.
hours with the flamboyants.
You won't get me out there.
And why not?
Remember, we live in a smart residential district. All stuck-up posh people.
Forget about the neighbors. If they see us and they want to join us, we'll make room for them.
Martha, if I am hurting you...
Have courage, Mama, and you will discover a new world. Here you see the blood of all men in the flowers of the compliments.
Let's stop tormenting her.
Go with Clarita.
It doesn't really matter if I don't.
Go with her.
Encendida calle antillana va, tembandumba, te la guindamos.